Hi guys, I'm Rafael Marcolino and welcome to Dremel Sapiens every week with a new Dremel lesson for you. Today I'm gonna talk about the four different versions of the single paradiddle. So that means that we actually have three different variations beyond the single paradiddle that we all know how to play. They are called inward paradiddle, reverse paradiddle, and outward paradiddle, and I'm gonna show them all to you in this lesson. And I think getting to know and to play these single paradiddle variations is a great way to develop dynamic control with your hands, because we're gonna step into some cool techniques of controlling which note we are accenting and which notes we are playing in a low volume, things like controlled strokes and pullouts. And these details, in my opinion, puts you in a really advanced direction. So let's get started with the single paradiddle, that it's our first variation of the lesson. So the basic single paradiddle, probably you know how to play, is right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left. But there is one really important detail that we are gonna have to pay attention in all those four variations, that we have to accent the first note of each four note cycle, and the other notes you have to play as low as you can. So the dynamics of the paradiddle are a really important part of these rudiments. Some rudiments don't have accent patterns inside of it, but most paradiddle variations have this, and we have to respect that. So for the single paradiddle, we play an accented stroke with our right hand, left, right, right in a lower volume, an accented stroke with our left hand, right, left, left in a lower volume. And when breaking down those dynamics inside the paradiddle, for me it's easier to look at it using the molar technique point of view. So for the molar technique, we have basically three different kinds of strokes: the downstroke, the tap, and the upstroke. The tap and the upstroke represents the same volume, the same dynamics, but the upstroke is what prepares us to play a downstroke with the same hand in a sequence. So when we think about which stroke we are playing in each note of the single paradiddle, it's like this: down, up, tap, tap, down, up, tap, tap, down, up, tap, tap, down, up, tap, tap, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left, right. So these are the mechanics of the single paradiddle. And when you start thinking about those downstrokes, taps, and upstrokes, makes it a lot easier to control those dynamics inside the single paradiddle. That might be kind of obvious because we are all used to playing the single paradiddle since the beginning of studying drums, probably. But when we start talking about those other three variations that I'm gonna show you now, that's not that obvious. So it's really good to break it down, thinking about each stroke and how we are playing each stroke of the rudiment, because of those dynamics that we have to pay attention to. So our second variation is gonna be the inward paradiddle. So instead of playing the double stroke in the end of each four note pattern, we're gonna now bring those two strokes with the same hand to the second and third notes of each four note pattern. So we're gonna play right, left, left, right, left, right, right, left. That's the inward paradiddle. And that changes everything when we start talking about downstrokes, taps, and upstrokes, because now our sequence becomes down, tap, up, tap, down, tap, up, tap, down, tap, up, tap, down, tap, up, tap, down. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, one. Right, left, left, right, left, right, right, left, right. That's the inward paradiddle. Now to the next variation. It's called reverse paradiddle. And the name is quite obvious because we're gonna start the pattern with the double stroke. But again, all these variations have the accented note on the first note, and the other notes in the sequence are in the lower volume. So we're gonna play this double stroke, accenting the first one and playing the second one really low. And it has to be played in the same volume that we are gonna play the rest of the sequence. And that's not an easy thing to do. And that's actually called the controlled stroke. It's when you accent the first stroke and you play a second stroke with the same hand in a lower volume. So the sequence of strokes, thinking about the Mahler technique, thinking about down strokes, taps, and up strokes, is the same of the inward paradiddle. If we think just the sequence of each type of stroke we are playing, in this variation we are playing down, tap, up, tap, down, tap, up, tap. But the sequence of hands that we are playing is completely different. So we have a control stroke in the beginning, right, right, left, right, left, left, right, left. So that's the reverse paradiddle. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, one. And now to the last variation of these single paradiddle variations. It's called the outward paradiddle. And if you look to each beat of the outward paradiddle isolated, seems to be a single stroke roll, but it's actually not a single stroke roll because we are alternating the leading hand for each beat, like the other paradiddle variations. So the sequence now is right, left, right, left, left, right, left, right. So now we have what we call a pull out. It's when you play two strokes in a row with the same hand, but accenting the second stroke. That happens in the end of each four note pattern to the first note of the next pattern. So it's right, left, right, left, left, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, right. So we're playing the upstroke and the downstroke in a row. That's what we call the pull out. And that's why the name of this paradiddle variation is outward paradiddle, because it has these pull outs in every beat. So the outward paradiddle is one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, one. There are some really cool things to analyze from these rudiments, from these paradiddle variations. The first one is that you don't need to use muscle strength to play the accented notes. It's actually all about how high you lift your drumstick and you let it fall to create a higher volume note. So that's why we have the upstroke to create this larger space between the drumstick and the surface for us to let it fall and have a higher volume stroke. So the goal here is to play as relaxed as you can and also have control of the dynamics that you are playing with each stroke. And I think playing these paradiddle variations is a very good exercise to develop hand control in terms of dynamics. It helps a lot to develop your weak hand, your left hand, to playing ghost notes and compared to backbeats inside a groove. And now I'm gonna show you a very cool exercise using all of those variations to build up your hand control. So we're gonna repeat one bar of each variation in a sequence. So we're gonna play one bar of the single paradiddle, one bar of the inward paradiddle, one bar of the reverse paradiddle, and one bar of the outward paradiddle in the same sequence. And just another quick tip, if you're not used to playing those paradiddle variations yet, if it's the first time you are trying to play those, try playing them in a really slow tempo. Start playing it without a metronome in the beginning, just for you to understand those mechanics and how those dynamics work, how those accented notes work, because that's the most important thing when playing the paradiddles, okay? Then you turn on your metronome and start in slow tempos. I advise you to start around 50, 60 beats per minute. I'm gonna play this exercise in 80 beats per minute. I'm gonna turn on my metronome here, but if you are not used to playing those variations, I really recommend you to try them a lot slower at first. But if you feel like you can play those in 80 beats per minute, you can play together with me. I'm gonna play it for a while with my practice pad for you to understand what exactly is this exercise and for you to try to play it with me, okay? Let's do it. One, two, three, four. 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 One. So as I said, this is a very good exercise to develop the control of dynamics with your hands. And if you want to take it off the practice pad and apply it to the kit in grooves or fills, you have many different possibilities. I posted a lesson a few weeks ago about creating grooves with the single paradiddle and the inward paradiddle, but you can use the same strategy with the reverse paradiddle and the outward paradiddle. I'm gonna put the link here on the description of the video. If you are watching this lesson on Instagram, this lesson is posted on my Instagram TV, so just search for the single paradiddle and inward paradiddle groove lesson. And you can use all those variations on the way I show in that lesson or in any other way that you use the single paradiddles and other variations, other versions of paradiddles, okay? I hope you liked this lesson. Don't forget that if you want to receive PDF files containing transcriptions of all those exercises, you just have to go to subscribe.drumosapiens.com and subscribe to the mailing list, and I see you on the next lesson.